After winning the world championship in 1994, you see their respective ages. Hurtado 2 years the older. He's also 1 inch taller. They're even in reach. They weighed in within a half pound of the 140-pound limit. And tonight, as they enter the ring unofficially, Hurtado weighs 151 and Bailey 149. Rules of the bout with our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Lederman.
Jim, the Randall Bailey Diabelis Hurtado fight is scheduled for 12 rounds using the unified rules that you see on your screen. Real quickly, let's go over the 4 points that the judges are going to use to score each individual round. Clean punching, effective aggressiveness, ring generalship, and defense with a strong emphasis on clean, effective punching. Jim.
All right, thank you very much, Harold Lederman. And right now, as Hurtado enters the ring, let me clarify, he won an amateur world championship in 1994 while fighting for Cuba. He won a junior amateur world championship years before that in 1990. And shortly after winning the amateur world championship in 94 on an amateur boxing trip to Foxwoods Casino in Connecticut, he defected to the USA.
And because he defected way back then, 8 years ago, he told us that his brother, who is a star baseball player in Cuba, one of the best on the island, is not allowed to leave the island on international baseball trips.
And there is Hurtado, who knocked both Pernell Whitaker and Costazu down early in his battles against those two terrific fighters, wound up losing both of those fights, but proved in the process that he's dangerous in the early going. And, of course, in losing to Costazu, he lost to one of the biggest punchers in the sport. Now he gets ready to take on another fighter who might occupy that stratosphere of punching power. Randall Bailey, who's only got one loss in his professional career and has scored knockouts in every other one of his fights.
Randall Bailey may be as big a puncher in his division as Felix Trinidad is in his. He's one of the biggest one-punch punchers in the game.
Devastating power with both the left and the right hand. His trainer, Al Banani, says, I'm trying to get him to box more. I'm trying to get him to use angles and defend himself better. But when a guy has this much power, sometimes it's easier just to go the shortest route between 2 points.
Of all of the good 140-pounders out there, he looks like the best bet to be able to move up to the welterweight division because of his size and his punch.
But to maintain his present prominence, he must beat Hurtado tonight. So for Randall Bailey against Ila Bailey, Hurtado, let's go into the ring for Jimmy Lennon Jr. and the pre-fight introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, good evening and welcome. Bienvenidos, aficionados del box, al Coliseo Roberto Clemente en San Juan, Puerto Rico. Tenemos una gran noche de boxeo. We have a big night of action brought to you by Don King Productions in association with Empresas Angelo Medina, HBO Sports, and the undisputed king of beers, Budweiser. Bien, amigos, este es el campeonato vacante peso super ligero de la AMB. This bout is sanctioned by the WBA, the president, Gilberto Mendoza, supervisor, Bolivar y Casa. Introducing our judges, scoring the bout from ringside, presentando a los jueces. From Venezuela, Rafael Carabaño. From Puerto Rico, Samuel Conde. And from Venezuela, Gonzalo Riveras. And our referee in charge, working in this his 34th world title bout, el referee es Luis Pabon. All right, fans, here we go. 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBA Super Lightweight Championship of the World. Presentando en la esquina roja. Introducing first in the red corner, wearing red trunks with black trim, fighting out of Miami, Florida, by way of Santiago, Cuba. Pesando 140 libras, his weight 140 pounds, su récord 34 victorias, 2 derrotas y un empate con 22 ganadas por knockout. His record stands at 34 wins, 2 losses, 1 draw with 22 wins coming by way of knockout. Ranked number 2 in the world by the WBA. Clasificado número 2, peso superligero, presentando de Obelis Hurtado. Y su oponente en la esquina azul, his opponent across the ring in the blue corner, wearing both the colors of the United States and Puerto Rico, red, white, and blue, hailing from Miami, Florida. Tiene un peso de 139 libras y media. He weighed in at 139 and one half pounds. Tiene un sobresaliente récord de 25 victorias y una derrota con 25 ganadas por knockout. His record, 25 wins, one loss, all 25 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the hard-hitting interim WBA super lightweight champion of the world. Demos la bienvenida a Randall Bailey. Once again, our referee in charge, Luis Pavón.
Okay, many people here. Okay. Hey, coming. Bien. Bailey. Okay, Bailey. Okay, listen to me. You are a professional. Don't want a low punch. When I say break, stay back and don't punch. When I interfere, nobody punch. Dejame a quien punch, okay? Usted es un profesional. No quiero golpe de la cintura para abajo. Cuando yo diga break, usted da un paso atrás sin tirar. Cuando yo intervenga, no quiero que tire. Su pantalón está un poco alto. Yo, el golpe bajo es de aquí para abajo. ¿Estamos claros?
To show you how weird this game can be, the organization that has Costa Zoo as its super champion.
No puede trabajar así.
Rates Bailey a champion and Hurtado as the number one contender. No other organization has either one ranked at all.
Are you ready?
They're just both good fighters, and we expect a good fight.
Yeah, but they're not ranked by other organizations because they're bad fighters. They're just not ranked by other organizations because of the unusual politics of boxing.
That's exactly what I was saying.
Yeah.
Now, this is a good night for punchers. Both guys are punchers. Carroll should go for a knockout and not play around because Bailey can box and he can punch. He circles around with power. Those are the fighters you don't want to be around in the ring for a lot of rounds.
And already you see how Bailey commits to his punches as the first right hand is thrown with fight-ending intention.
He also is balanced well on his feet. He bounces back after every punch.
Knocks Hurtado into the ropes with a left hook and then catches him high on the top of the head with another left hook, not even thrown at full force. Hurtado is willing in the early rounds to exchange. Then he tries to move away.
Hurtado has been in with a well-experienced fighter, so he's not going to be overwhelmed or intimidated by the experience of Bailey. Just his power.
In Hurtado's first round with Costa Zoo, Zoo knocked him down, then he knocked Zoo down twice. He floored Whitaker in both the first and sixth rounds before Whitaker finally reeled him in and knocked him out in the 11th. Bailey lands another big left hook inside.
You watch Bailey, he bounces in and out before he does anything. And he's got power.
He used to talk, George, about how Felix Trinidad sets up in that sprinter's position with his back heel off the canvas.
Going forward, always on your mark, go.
And Randall Bailey has the same stance.
But he'll back forward. He'll take off backwards.
Big right hand misses to Bailey. Hurtado comes back with a combination of his own.
Bailey is not committed to just going forward. He will back away, and if you push him, he'll circle you.
Fighters using a new Grant glove, which has been designed to be more of a puncher's glove than was the previous Grant glove. This is called the new Bailey, or the new Grant mini glove. And Randall Bailey is particularly excited about it, says that he thinks it will blend well with his punching power approach to boxing.
You know, if you can punch, gloves don't play a part of it. If you can't punch, you better look for anything you can. A glove.
But boxers, like ball players, are notoriously superstitious, George, and they like to touch certain things and be touched by certain things.
Yeah, it's all about superstition more than any true knowledge.
Hard right hand by Bailey. Drives Hurtado back. Hurtado takes the left hand, lands a right hand of his own. When we go to Hurtado's corner where they speak Spanish, our interpreter is Ray Torres.
Okay, deep breath. Come on now. Deep breath. Listen to me. Move. Even if you don't move too much, but still move a little bit. Move your head continually. Don't get so close. He can't hit you only from the outside.
Take everything out. You give him some water?
Real nice.
Okay, take another swim. Here's the spit bucket right here, dog.
Doing real good. Don't get carried. All right? Doing great.
Get this out. Like I'm going to pick him up.
You look like a world champion. He's at school.
You take it. Excellent work. You got it.
Bailey's corner, so happy with their fighter in the first round, they're ready to leave the ring with about 20 seconds to go before the end of the break.
Hands up.
CompuBox numbers in round one. Bailey 7 out of 27. They were almost all hard shots. Hurtado 11 out of 50. Hurtado 3 of 25 jabs. Bailey 1 of 6. So obviously it is Hurtado who tries to use the jab and work behind it.
That's what you want if you're Hurtado, to make Bailey throw a lot of his power away. He's a power puncher. Make him throw it away and be out there thinking, I don't have any more.
But you probably don't want to stand still against the ropes and let Bailey hammer away against your ribs.
Bailey's not looking at him, as you see, when he's throwing shots. He just put his head right in front of Hurtado's chest and doesn't even look at what he's doing. So there's no danger there. It's when they're doing it with their eyes, that's when you better be afraid.
Hurtado blocking some of Bailey's body shots with his arms, not all.
Bailey's the kind of guy that likes things in the middle of the ring. He'll knock you down if you're in front of him, but he needs the middle of the ring to do it out of the boxer's position. On the ropes, he's insecure. He thinks he may miss you and you may get him. Backs away from the rope.
Bailey's last knockout of Demetrius Savalos on the undercard. Oh, and down goes Bailey from a quick right-hand counter shot by Hurtado.
Three, four, five,
that's exactly
six,
how he got
seven,
his other knockdowns
eight.
Against Zouz and Whitaker.
That's only the second time that Randall Bailey's been down in his career. He was knocked down once by Aner Julio of Colombia in his only loss, which was also on the undercard of a Trinidad fight, Trinidad versus Mamadou Thiam in Miami, July 22, 2000.
Now, the good thing about it is he has Hurtado reaching out at him. That's what you want him to do, get out of his combination counterpunching stuff.
There is a cut over the right eye of Bailey.
A trickle of blood, and Bailey, you saw, knocked off balance by another Hurtado right hand. This has been a huge round for Hurtado.
Hurtado now is going back to going up against the ropes. That's what you want to do. Just because you knocked this puncher down, don't get overconfident. Start reaching at him.
Hurtado's experience with better fighters showing very well in the first round as he weathered Bailey's aggression. And here in the second round, as he calmly let Bailey punch at him, and then he stepped in with his own counter.
Perfectly timed counter. Just a perfect right-hand shot off of Bailey left hook.
Get the count.
Listen to me, Tampa. You can't throw one punch. You hear what I'm trying to tell you?
Right.
Hey!
Get the
mouthpiece and give him some water.
Listen, you're throwing one punch at a time, okay?
Okay.
Open your mouth, baby. Get the spit bucket up if you can. All right, let's go. Come on. Easy.
Okay.
Headbutt?
Yeah.
All right.
Hurtado covers up very well as Bailey flings his punches and steps in with a short, quick, accurate right hand. Boom.
Bailey actually sat on the ropes and did that. He didn't reach in. He sat down. Back, boom. Touch the ropes and punch. Those are frightening punches.
In round two, Hurtado landed 21 out of 36 power shots, 58%. So it was, as I mentioned, a huge round for Diabelis Hurtado.
Can you imagine being knocked down and you're still following a guy around? You've got to find a way to make Hurtado follow you around.
Well, this is Bailey. He's all offense. And you heard Al Benanti between corners saying, you're only throwing one punch at a time. I want you to throw them in combination. He was, in effect, asking Bailey to step up his offense as his own defense. Bailey reaching with the right hand. Hurtado looking for another chance to counter. Hurtado sitting in the same position as in the last round, hoping to land a similar shot.
He's going to make his back touch the rope before he throws anything. This is when you go to the body with your jab. Keep your punches. Don't go on top for a while. Start jabbing to the body, throwing that same right hand around the side. Neither fighter's thrown anything to the body yet. That left jab of Bailey should be going to the chest.
Well, Bailey's unveiled the jab here in the third round after not having used it much in the first two rounds. He seems to have decided he wants to go to a more patient style of attack. And now, as he uses the jab to try to set up his right hand, he's more effective.
He's not effective at all. As a matter of fact, he's throwing away his power. Those jabs are coming with mean intent. You see, if he would just throw those punches to the chest and to the shoulder, he'd connect. Got to give up throwing for the head. If you throw to the chest, the guy's knocked backwards.
So what you're saying is, Bailey's like the pitcher who only knows how to throw at one speed, huh?
No, he should be throwing that jab to the chest.
Gotcha.
The speed is okay, but throw it to the chest. This guy's backing away when you throw to the jab. He sits on the rope. And that's the hardest thing to get a young fighter to throw to the chest.
Meanwhile,
these are experienced fighters.
Hurtado does exactly what you're talking about as he fires his jab to the chest.
That's what you want to do. You can't miss. Plus, it throws your opponent off.
Right hand for Bailey. And a left hook to the body by Bailey. And another perfect counter by Hurtado as once again he bounced off the ropes with the right hand.
Hurtado gets this guy out in the middle of the ring, hits him two or three times, and then back away and says, come and get me back. And he falls into the trap every time. You see? Bailey can turn this thing around if he keeps the fight in the middle of the ring.
Incidentally, that whistle tells you there are 10 seconds to go in the round. It's Tuesday. Check out the next Real Sports with Bryant Gumbel. Among the stories, a look at golfer Phil Mickelson. He's made tens of millions of dollars, has 20 wins on the Pro Tour, and is a four-time member of the Ryder Cup team. His albatross, Mickelson's never won a major championship. We'll follow Phil as he prepares for the U.S. Open and find out what makes him tick. Real Sports, nothing is out of bounds.
You just got to move, throw, you know. He's not going to do nothing to you. You hear me? Do you hear me? You gotta hit him more. Don't get over anxious. He can't hit you. Keep your hands up.
Just don't get careless when you're throwing too many punches.
Yeah.
Okay?
Tie him up once in a while on the inside. All right, let's go.
Come on, baby.
Second so, huh?
Here's a riddle, George. If a guy has a big punch but he doesn't land it, is he a big puncher?
Yep, still a big puncher. You want to make certain that the big punch never lands it.
Because he might land it someday. That's right. Harold, how do you have it through three?
Okay, Jim, I got it all even 28-28 in rounds 2-1, Randall Bailey. I thought Randall Bailey certainly outworked Diabelis Hurtado in the first round. Second round, big for Diabelis Hurtado. He gets an extra point for the knockdown. The third round, Randall Bailey came back and he outworked him again, landed hard shots, just as he is right now.
I have Hurtado ahead 2-1.
Bailey seemed to be falling for every little trick. Here's a guy with not a whole lot of experience. He's the one pulling tricks on Bailey.
Well, Bailey only had 84 amateur fights compared to hundreds of amateur fights Diabelis Hurtado had prior to defecting from Cuba. So in that area of their careers, it is Hurtado who had more experience. As professionals in the USA, Bailey has more.
Bailey hits him with a right. Tata hits him back with a left. That's what you want to do. Make him pay for every time he throws something.
Big uppercut by Bailey. And Hurtado shaking his head as if to wipe away the fog from that one shot.
It was preceded by two good body shots, which is what Bailey has to do. He's headhunting too much.
The thing about it, his height is so great that when, once he sticks that head down, he catches it. Now Bailey's trying to be the counterpuncher. That's not his game.
Keep moving, keep moving. Angle, angle.
Nobody throw, nobody throw. Wait, you
know. The crowd here is watching this fight with some interest, but no passion. Neither of these fighters mean much here in San Juan. This is a fight that ideally would be held in Miami, where both fighters live.
Bailey is still walking down, walking his opponent down, not throwing any shots, standing right there in front of him.
Meanwhile, as we coast toward the end of the fourth round of this hard shot trading fight between Hurtado and Bailey. If you watched Felix Trinidad's loss to Bernard Hopkins last September 29 in Madison Square Garden, you may recall the incident prior to the fight when Trinidad was forced by the New York State Athletic Commission's observers at the behest of Hopkins' representative in his locker room to rewrap his hands, to remove the wrapping and replace the hand wrapping after it had already been done. Moments ago, in Hasim Sharifi's locker room, Papa Trinidad, Felix Sr., posed a protest against the way that Sharifi's hands had been wrapped. This is a look on tape at the argument moments ago and the moment at which Sharifi's trainer began removing the tape as it had been placed on the hands because officials here agreed with Papa Trinidad and decided that Sharifi should rewrap his hands, forcing Hasim to go through the same distraction that Felix faced before his loss in New York.
Yeah, and Felix Sr. called what Bernard Hopkins did sports terrorism.
Tonight he engages in a little of the same thing, as there's a live shot. The previous shot was taped. This is live of Hasim Sharifi getting his hand wrapped for a second time with the commission's observers from here in Puerto Rico. And in a, you know, curious replay of what happened in New York.
Bailey's corner's done an excellent job of keeping that cut closed. There hasn't been any other blood, and he's always had consistently good cut people in his corner. First counterpunch by Bailey. Right hand.
A tackle worthy of a Miami Hurricane.
This is when you want to get in a punch, not a tackle. For Bailey, trying to wrestling game, but you, this guy is smart.
It'll work.
Wolf got him again with the same right hand. Leaning in, Bailey did. Also, again, by not moving to the left or to the right, just straight in.
Giving Hurtado another chance at the perfect counter.
Tyler just waits his time. He's going to throw it. Now he realizes he's got to work Bailey a little bit, so he comes in the middle of the ring, get a few points ahead, then back away.
Bailey leaning forward.
No holding.
Always looking to mount the power attack. Hurtado trying to use Bailey's aggression against him.
That's exactly what he's doing.
Both fighters are so concerned with the striking power of the other fighter that the fight has become more tactical than expected.
Yeah, whenever strength and power lets you down, you're never confident in it again. And that's what has happened to both of these guys. They've been overpowering guys, and it didn't work. They're not doing that anymore.
Clean fight.
They start saying, Mama didn't raise no fool.
Well, you sort of suspect if anybody has an arsenal of boxing skills on which to fall back here, it would be Hurtado. Bailey's such a devastating puncher that he has had a natural tendency to rely on that.
Bailey, for the first time, reached in with a nice right hand. Logan Powell just reached in for accuracy, and that was the best thing he's done so far. You don't try to hit these guys with power. Just land the shot.
Oh, and as the bell sounds, Bailey gets in a right-hand shot on Hurtado, but Hurtado was turning away and rolled with the punch. Moments ago, the hand wrapping scene in Felix Trinidad's dressing room, and Hasan Sharifi's people were there to watch and had no objection whatsoever to the way that Felix Trinidad Sr., Papa Trinidad, wrapped the hands. You see anything questionable there, George?
That's terrible. There's no way I would allow an opponent to wrap his hand with that much padding. That's just too much padding. It's got to be more than two wraps, hand wrap.
It's astonishing to you that Sharifi's people would stand there and watch and allow them to do that?
Astonishing. I don't understand it.
If you had an opponent wrapping his hands like that, you'd
he
want
would have to stop. You got
to
use one roll of gall. That's all. That's more than one roll. If a guy's wrapping his hand of that sort, that means he's got trouble with his hands, broken his knuckle a few times. Make him afraid to throw his hard shot. That's terrible.
Interesting. And this is exactly what Bernard Hopkins said after the fight in New York, that he believed maybe Trinidad had gotten away with illegal hand wraps for years.
I want you to know that wrap is not going to help Trinidad with his power at all. Just going to
but
keep his knuckles
his
from
hands.
Being, protect his knuckles from being hurt.
He's the kind of puncher, George, with the kinds of hands that often have difficulty from fight to fight and get hurt over the years. And Felix has never had a big history of bad hand problems.
You want punchers to have hurt hands, I tell you that. Well, make them hurt their hands.
So that even if it doesn't add to his power,
it does not add to his power.
If it protects his hands, that's
it's
a help.
Bad. It's a help.
Remarkable. Round six of a scheduled 12 here. Randall Bailey of the United States in the blue, red, and white trunks, and he knocks Hurtado down with a right hand over the top.
Three, cuatro, cinco.
Delayed reaction.
Siete, ocho, levanta la mano.
Like a parachute that opened 5 seconds after the guy jumped out of the plane.
That's the kind of power Bailey has. Heavy-handed shot.
Hurtado has got to go back to the rope. That's what Bailey's insecure. Hang around those ropes.
Three rounds ago, I was about to mention, before Hurtado deposited Bailey on the canvas with his shot, that Bailey's last knockout of Demetrius Sabalas on the undercard of Bernard Hopkins, Carl Daniels, February 2 in Reading, Pennsylvania, was of the nervous-making variety. It left Sabalos unconscious on the canvas for 2 or 3 minutes. Ultimately, he was okay.
Think about Hurtado. He's got that Cuban background. Some skill involved in his style.
He absolutely.
Knows. Bailey's trying to figure out how can I avoid following this guy around. Now he's got a little circle to his march. Bailey does.
I'm here. Nobody throw.
So here in round six, the momentum clearly shifts in Randall Bailey's favor as he scores a knockdown of Hurtado, and Hurtado's punch output seems to begin to decline.
Okay, you gotta fight with this guy. Let's go. Is anything wrong? There's nothing wrong. Get something on the ear. Let me look in your ear. Something in your ear. Okay, you gotta fight him now.
Hey, Rand, listen to me carefully. That uppercut inside is gonna work, okay? You use your jab now. When he starts just falling down, you use your jab, okay?
The record shows that when these fighters fight, guys go down. Hurtado went down.
Right hand on the ear.
Yeah, it was on the temple and sent a delayed message
right on the ear,
to his brain to go down and take a knee.
Yeah, and that's what's still bothering him, that ear. I think it cut the ear, George. Yeah. He's got a little cut right in front of the ear along his cheek there.
They told Hurtado in his corner that he has to go out and fight Bailey now, and that's what he's come to do.
Well, let's see if he has to fight Bailey. Harold, how do you have it through six?
Okay, Jim, 57-55, four rounds to two, Randall Bailey. Give an extra point to Diabella Hurtado for the knockdown in round two, an extra point to Randall Bailey for the knockdown in round six. Other than that, 10-9 rounds. Jim, I like the big punching Randall Bailey. I think he's just landing the hardest shots, and Diabella Hurtado is not doing enough. He's not outworking him. I mean, basically, we're looking at a boxer against the puncher. In this fight, I'm going with the puncher because I think he's doing more. One word about the hand wraps. The old rule used to be you could use 10 yards of soft gauze on each hand. When trainers would come along and say they'd like to use a little more, they all used to agree. So the WBC said, listen, if you guys are going to agree to use more, we're going to cut out the rule, period. So now it's 10 yards as a measuring stick, one roll, just as George said, but there is no rule as to how much gauze you can use.
Yeah, the question is, should you be able to layer it twice over the hitting area, as we saw them doing there?
That was terrible. Hurtado was able to get in a right to the body of Bailey. That hurt. Bailey's going to be holding for a minute or two now because that right side, left side is hurting.
No holding.
And just as you predicted, Bailey momentarily slows down.
Yeah, he's got to regroup a little bit. He'll get his wind back, but right now, that goes to the body again.
Now Hurtado has Bailey going.
They told him to go out and fight, and he's fighting.
I'll tell you what, he's got courage, and he knocks Bailey down for the second time. Two-fisted attack by Diabella Hurtado, coming under with uppercuts.
And Bailey seems very hurt.
It's that body shot.
It was a body shot. I agree with George. It was a body shot.
It's done. Diabella Hurtado finally reels in a big one. After falling short in his bids to knock out Costazu and Pernell Whitaker, this time Hurtado seals the deal.
The reason this fight took so long to make, Jim, was that Don King originally wanted options on Hurtado to make this fight. So Hurtado's camp went to court, and the court ruled you don't have to give options. So Hurtado's promoters and managers have him free and clear Bailey has been stopped.
So Hurtado wins twice. He wins the court fight that prevents him from having to sign options with King, and then he wins the fight unexpectedly. And George, from round one on, even as Harold Letterman saw Bailey slipping into the lead, you kept saying Hurtado was doing the right thing.
Yeah, I didn't see him slip into the lead at all because I saw him following this guy around, a puncher around, and getting his dude paid bell rung over and over and over. Don't follow a puncher.
Through the accumulation of punishment and through the two-fisted attack in the middle of the seventh, Diabelis Hurtado becomes the winner.
There's that shot. That hurt.
That was the body shot.
That hurt.
And you pointed out at that moment, George, you said he's in trouble now.
And those are the worst kind because you just can't recover or shake it off like you would a punch in the head. And that's a matter of just cleaning up what you've already cut down.
And give credit to Hurtado for sensing how badly he had hurt Bailey with the body shot.
Yeah, his corner told him to wake up. He woke up.
Yeah, and give Hurtado a lot of credit because he has gone to school over the last several years on how he lost to Whitaker and Zhu. He was the guy on top at the end this time.
And he was young enough to recover from all of that.
So it's the 35th victory of Diabelis Hurtado's career, the 23rd by knockout. Let's go up to ring announcer Jimmy Lennon Jr. for the official particulars.
Damas y caballeros, tenemos el tiempo, 2:10 en round número 7. Ladies and gentlemen, the time, 2:10 in round number 7. The winner by way of knockout, el ganador por knockout, el nuevo campeón and new WBA super lightweight champion, Diabelis Hurtado.
Final CompuBox numbers, and you can see that Hurtado wound up landing 20 more punches, throwing 62 more. They connected at exactly the same percentage, so Hurtado consistently the slightly busier fighter throughout the fight. Power punches, the area where Randall Bailey was hoping to convert and create victory for himself, but Hurtado landed more power punches, threw more power punches, and connected at a higher percentage. Ultimately, he's the one who knocked Bailey down twice, not vice versa, and that creates the win.